The truck is somewhere near that church in the town square. The place is crawling with Japs. We need the demolition on the truck to build this bridge.
Now you just hang fire for a minute. I'll be giving the order. Clear this area out so we get to that tank.
Thank you.
chewing us up. Now they've got a spotter and an observation post somewhere. I'll be up high in one of those buildings. They'll have a radio relay station nearby. Find a boat and knock them out. We'll hold here. Got a lot riding on you, Marine. Don't let us down.
Let's go.
Corporal, you find some way to signal the demo team. I'll check out this truck. I bet you keep your eyes peeled for Jax. Bumpy ride. Hold on!
Look, look, look. Keep going! There's more jumps on the way!
You make sure you and that tank reach the bridge before we light it up.
Lad. Listen, son, I'm sorry about your brother. We got a damn tough job done, and most of us made it out alive. He was a good Marine. You can't ask for more than that.
With American armed forces now fully engaged in war, Japanese-occupied South Pacific islands are feeling the pressure. But hopes are crushed for a swift Allied victory in the Philippines. After a long, bloody battle, General MacArthur is ordered to retreat. Thousands of troops are left behind and forced to surrender. The enemy now controls the Philippines. MacArthur vows to return. In a bold offensive move, the United States prepares to land 10,000 troops on Guadalcanal, a relatively unknown island, where a strategic airfield is under construction by Japanese forces.
Dear Joe, I have no idea if you've been told yet, but I have terrible news. Yesterday we got a telegram, the kind everyone dreads. Mom refused to open it until Dad rushed home from work. It was about Donnie. He's missing in action in the Philippines. We've tried to get more information from the War Department, but all we know is Donnie and some of the other men in his unit are unaccounted for. Mom's taking this very hard. She's holding on to the hope that Donnie's just been separated from the other Marines, that he made it out of the battle but hasn't been able to report back yet. Maybe it's just some awful mistake. Dad says that can happen sometimes, right? For now, all we can do is pray for another telegram with better news. Somehow, I know it will come. I decided I had to do something to take my mind off things, to help the war effort. With all the men gone overseas, a lot of the girls are working in the factories now. I applied for a job down at the Atlas Steel plant, and I start on Monday. Where are you, Joe? Your last letter had so many holes cut out by the sensors that it looked like a sieve. But please, write again. It means so much to us to hear from you, especially now. Love, Mary.